Namaskar everybody. Lot of adjustment we did, but still we did not align the
spine
of the screen. No problem, that is life. And now we will start. So first of all, let us align ourselves into these chairs. Your hips should be touching the wall of the chair. At the same time, your upper back. Yes, excellent. Try to relax your shoulders and try to relax your elbows. At the same time, relax your knees and relax your ankles. Sit comfortably. Keep your palms on your thighs. We'll just relax. As all of us have come through notorious traffic of Bangalore, where a lot of cementing is going on, so all of us might be, you know, slightly toned up, stiff. So let us relax first. I request all of you to close your eyes, palms facing the sky. Forget all the tensions, worries. Forget about what traffic you have come through. Forget about this misalignment of the screen. And breathe deep. Focus only on your breathing. When you inhale, try to bulge your abdomen. When you exhale, try to suck your abdomen in. Focus on your spine. Do you feel that it is in its most erect position? If not, then slowly adjust, rise, become straighter. But in a relaxed manner. Do not stiff yourself like a soldier. Like a meditator, you relax yourself into erect position of the spine. I request all of you to chant Omkara 3 times. After I say inhale, you start chanting. If you do not want, if it does not come to your belief or you are in a peace, you can just hum like a bee, like that, okay? Inhale. And he brought all of us saying spine and spirit, and is giving a stone kalli kodta idare kaiyalli. So just see it, feel it, and transfer it. Meanwhile, ponder over it. It has some meaning. It has this stone will come in the end also of this whole lecture. So anybody wants to ask a question in this line? Almost this line is finished.
Yau betta.
She is asking this rock belongs to which betta? Okay. Fine. So basically she wants to ask that where this stone come from. Okay. Where is the stone? It's very precious, okay? You have to return me back. Any geologist here? Anybody interested in rocks, minerals, gemstones? Sir, it has not yet come to you. General knowledge. Oh, that is the best knowledge. So, sir, please apply your general knowledge and tell me if you know the name of this rock. Yes? What did it?
Granite.
Yes, it is the most common rock found in our homes, but I am sorry, it is not granite. It is brother of granite. Sedimented rock. So, very nice general knowledge. Yeah, I appreciate it. There are different types of rocks. Okay.
Igneous.
Oh wow, excellent. Your spirit is becoming high. Very nice. Igneous rock, metamorphic rock. So this rock is a metamorphic rock. Okay. So can we tell that this rock which you are seeing is the brother of granite? It is not granite. Can we say that how old is this stone? Just a guess.
Millions of years.
Millions of years. Okay. Before that, what was there?
Molten state.
Molten state. Before that?
Gas.
Gas. Before that?
Space.
Space. Atoms. Before that?
Stars.
Stars formed after the molten state. Sir, you want to say anything with your general knowledge? It looks like granite, but it is not granite. It is called gneiss, G-N-I-S-S, gneiss stone, and it is a metamorphic rock. Okay. So, why I chose, I am a neurosurgeon. I deal with life, correct? Do you think there is a life in this stone?
Yes, it is.
How?
But we can't see that, sir. All living objects in the earth is completely having life.
All the objects have life because we belong to the most ancient culture. That is why most of us will know that kan kan mein Bhagawan samaya hai. And kan kan mein Jeev samaya hai. Okay. But I want to give it a scientific perspective. So in what way this rock is going to give me the answers about life? Do you think this rock will give me the answers? Yes, definitely, otherwise this lecture will not move. So yes, all of us have this rock in our pockets. Anybody not having mobile? All of us have mobiles?
Yes.
Yes. Polish madre granite. Idu ella granite, but geologists ke helidre avaru GNISS. Gneiss, metamorphic rock anta. Idrinda means we can create granite also by polishing it too much. So
it is a semi precious stone because it is
sir, it is very precious because it has given me so much of knowledge.
Because lot of, you know, shining and stars are there inside.
Yes, yes. I will definitely come to that. Yes. So, the mobile also is formed out of 13 to 20 different types of rocks and minerals. Okay. So, it contains silica, sand, bauxite, the graphite, bastnaesite, silicon, tetrahedrite, arsenopyrite. Some of you might be knowing these names. And mobile phone is totally made up of rocks and minerals. But as it has been transformed, that is why it becomes of immense value and its function changes. This rock mostly can be used for construction or else for playing by children or else for paperweight use. Okay, but this rock can connect you to any part of the planet. Okay, so this question, no, I asked repeatedly that who created this rock, how this rock was created. This all things, by looking at a similar rock, our ancestors also had thought of. It is present in the Rigveda, the 10th mandala, 129th hymn, 1st to 7th sloka, the hymn of creation, Nasdiya Sukta Anta Hedtara. Otherly, they have thought, continuously thought, and ultimately what was the conclusion? The conclusion was, what steed, where, in whose protection, there was nothing beyond the how it came, what made it, and when this was produced, who knows from where it has arisen, and they ultimately put it to something called as God. Okay, and they thought that even if God created, he was mute because he was allowing lots and lots of mistakes to happen. Correct? Lots and lots of mistakes happened, and even if that happened, slowly the universe got created and ultimately we got created. Okay, so last line was, only he knows, or perhaps he also does not know. Means God, even if God has created, God knows it, how he created, or God also does not know. This is what it is written in Rig Veda. Do we have the answers, all the answers about creation of universe?
No.
But okay, still, the way they have dealt it, same way our current contemporary scientists are also dealing, and they are continuously researching, they are continuously trying to find the answers. So latest Western scientists, what they have given, which theory they have given?
Big Bang.
Big Bang theory. So Big Bang theory says that there was a Big Bang out of which the matter got created, and then matter dispersed, and then this is what happened. 15 billion years ago, the Big Bang happened, and then 10 billion years back, stars got created. 5 billion years ago, sun got created. Sun is very important to us. And then 4.5 billion years ago, the molten earth was there. And then finally, 3.8 billion years ago, water was there in liquid state. Okay. Now, where was this rock then? Where was this rock then? In the water. So, when the first life got created, it was, what is the chemical formula of water?
H2O.
When the first life got created, in addition to H2O in our body, how much H2O we have? 70% approximately. In addition to H2O, what do we have?
Carbon.
What are the bones made up of?
Calcium.
What is the blood containing because of which it is red?
Iron.
So all minerals are there in the body in different proportions. That is how there was relationship between water and the rock. Initially, it was a very simple chemical solution. Slowly, slowly, it became complex. It became so complex that it started having life-like properties. And that is how first cell was created. Okay? And slowly, slowly, we started having, what is this? Who told gems? How many people think that these are gems? How many people think that these are not gems? How many people are not listening to my lecture?
I am finding life in that.
It is like an airport. On the airport there will be landing and take off, no? So it is the place where life lands, life takes off. It is sand. It was the microscopic image of the sand. Okay. So sand is very minute and it created the, you know, port for life to stick on it, or the chemicals to bind together and then create cells. So why all these things? How many of you are wearing gems? Okay. We are all wearing the history of life, actually. And these things have gone in a lot of morphological changes because of which it becomes precious. Okay, if you break it, if you do a proper study of this, this is going to give answers about how life originated. Okay. Nobody wears these kind of things, no? What is this?
Fossils.
Fossils, yes. So this fossil is of an organism called as trilobite, which was present in this form 540 to 520 million years ago. What is our life expectancy? 80 to 120 years. Okay. So now, do you think that rocks can give answers to life? Yes, fossils can give answers to life. But for me as a neurosurgeon, can anybody tell what is there to see?
Spines.
Yes, there is a central structure, okay? A central structure which is very solid, which did not melt over the period of 520 or 540 million years. Why this did not melt? Anybody has a guess? Yes, we all know this, no? Shankha, shell, okay. This is made up of calcium. Calcium mineral is there, which is a very, very solid mineral, and it does not get affected. You see so many shells coming out of the ocean, no? When we go to any beach, it is our children's favorite pastime, no? To collect these shells. They are there in ocean for thousands and millions of years. They come out same in a fresh way. Okay, so that is how we have answers to life millions and billions of years ago.
Can we powder the shell and take?
Yeah, you can eat as a vitamin D supplement, calcium supplement. Definitely. What is this? How many are crab? How many are spiders? It is a spider. This is same trilobite. That previous picture was not showing that it was green in color. Okay, the green color was lost. In this picture it is showing that it was green in color. What is the significance of green color on this planet? Chlorophyll, photosynthesis. Out of nothing, how do you create energy? From sunlight, from photons. The early plants and animals, even animals, they had a capacity to convert light into energy, photosynthesis. So that is how we know that millions of years ago, the primary source of energy was sun. That is why sun is so near to us, and we daily, we give our air to sun. Okay. What is this? Bat.
Lizard.
Bird. What is the difference between the previous ones and this one?
Wings.
Wings. See, whatever calcium we were seeing was on the outside of all those animals. Now, there is calcium inside of these animals. Okay? So, what do you think? What is the difference? Calcium being outside and calcium being inside.
It gives strength and like a pillar.
So, the outside one is called as? Exoskeleton. It gives strength and protection. Okay. And it is used as a attacking agent also. Just in the case of crab or scorpion. Okay. Now, whatever we have, what do we have?
Endoskeleton.
Endoskeleton. Do we have exoskeleton? Nails. Hair. If it is more, then it will be classified as exoskeleton. So, endoskeleton, it gives support to the body, provides framework. As we all know, lot of you will be knowing bone marrow transplantation and all these things. So the blood is produced in the bone, okay, and it gives attachment for the muscles and it protects vital organs. Which is the most vital organ for us?
Kidney.
Kidney.
You can create war here. What do you think?
Brain.
Brain.
All are important. But yeah, whenever there is a teamwork, always there will be one captain, leader. So who is the leader? Central nervous system. Now we move on to, we go inside, we see the endoskeleton. This is the oldest endoskeleton of an animal named Australopithecus afarensis. It was a female skeleton and it was 3 million years old. It has been studied extensively and they found some fractures. And they found a spine. They found some ribs. They found some pieces of skull, jaw and all these things. And the way this animal had died was because of the fall from 42 feet height approximately. And based on all those investigations, they concluded that this was the oldest animal in the history which had walked on two legs with the spine erect. Okay. Now what is the significance of spine being erect in the process of evolution? Okay. You see what is happening. Australopithecus 35 to 25 lakh years back started walking. It was just 3 feet height, approximately 40 kgs. When the hands become free, what do we hold? What do we hold? Very good. Mobile. So, is it going to evolve us or devolve us, that we will see later. Okay. Next, what happened was, they started holding things which were, you know, very important for further survival, like bones. She told, no, powder and eat for calcium supplement. Then he used to eat bones also, become strong. In addition to the meat, then this stone. Because the hands were free, they started playing with the stones and friction, fire. Then they thought, okay, we are standing erect, we are coming in the range of so many animals. We can't fight with muscle. So what should we use? We should use mind. With free hands, they started chiseling the stones. They started chiseling bones and they created spears, arrows, and then going on and on, and then now we are having any sort of weapon. So that is how approximately 120,000 years ago Homo sapiens sapiens were born. We are Homo sapien androids. Okay. Or some people are iClouds. iOS. Now what exactly happened? This can be thought in two ways. Okay. One is what was leading to what? Okay. Now we do not know that why these animals started walking on two legs. Do we see dogs walking on two legs? Do we see elephants? They are almost of the similar existence range of us, but they have not walked on two legs. They had all the time on the planet, they had all the resources, but they have not utilized. Why only we were chosen? This is a big question. Okay. Now I have two-way theory about it. This has been projected as just an observational study, but as we are all the sons of this soil, we try to analyze it according to our culture and our spiritual knowledge. What I felt was, the nature wanted to manifest itself. Nature wants to manifest in the most beautiful, most intelligent and most gracious form. Okay. So at this point, it ticked on Australopithecus. And then Australopithecus started using both the four limbs, hands. Okay. Now, we all have mobiles? Yes. Consider it as a mobile. The human brain of Australopithecus is mobile. Okay. Australopithecus is downloading information with its hands. What information? What is this stone, whether it is igneous stone, metamorphic stone, or graphite or granite, whatever it is, or how can I eat it, can I smell it, can I wear it, any kind of wild imagination, they have done. We see the old eras, Harappa Sanskruti, how they had created all sorts of utensils and jewelry and all these things. So that information was getting downloaded in the brain. Now, this mobile has a capacity of 32 GB and your download is 64 GB. What to do? External slot disk. Correct? Was there any facility at that time that bring one more head and attach? No. So, there was stimulus. There was stimulus to the cranium here that yes, you have to now create some space, and then that is how initially, apparently the initial monkeys, their brain was only 50 grams, and now over the period of time, you can see this exponential curve, no? So many of you will be engineers, no? See this exponential curve which has come because of too much of overload of information with the help of hands, and because of erect posture, your range of vision and exploration, all these things becomes very, very high, and that led to expansion in the cranial cavity, and 1.5 kg brain we have now today. So it is approximately 30 times more than the first people who walked on the planet with humans. So it has implications. Okay? So now, enough of history, enough of evolution of life, and now we will dive from outer universe. We all studied about how it happened and how we became erect. Okay? And now we will go to the inner universe. What is the inner universe? Inner universe looks like this. Has anybody seen like this? This is human brain, then spinal cord. And if beautifully dissected, people have done this. I also have done in my first year of MBBS. All the nerves are seen. Here, these are motor nerves. This is the depiction of the sensory nerves. Okay. But in this beautiful anatomical diagram, what this Nandini Hall is doing?
Calcium.
Anybody has a...
No.
No calcium this time. It will be calcium overdoses otherwise. Now there is a very important message I want to elaborate on. That how Nandini works, anybody knows? Okay, I will explain it to you. Nandini takes milk from the farmers, from the rural area, pasteurizes it in the dairy circle, and then distributes it to the outlets. Okay. Now, suppose if farmers don't give Nandini the milk, what will happen? Nandini will stop sending it to the consumer. Okay. Can farmers utilize all that milk? If the outlets tell that no, we are not getting profit by you by selling your milk, we are not going to sell your milk, you keep in your factory, what will happen? It will get spoiled. Same happens here. Nandini Hall packet can solve all the problems of life. Now our hands, our skin, eyes, ears, our tongue, all the sensory organs, they give information to the brain. Whether they are giving useful information or useless information, depending upon that, the brain is going to process it. Brain has its own capacity to analyze things. Okay? That is called intellect. And if intellect is not helping, if intellect is low, means the pasteurization is not proper, then you are going to deliver bad milk to the society. And when society will drink bad milk, means your behavior or your existence in the society is not correct. That is your motor response in any ways, through speech, through body language, through your writing or through your work, anything for that matter. What will happen? You are going to evolve or you are going to degrade. Okay. So this is what I was speaking. So outside world, we get through ears, skin, eyes, tongue and the nose. We get all the information in the form of hearing, touch, sight, taste and smell. And then with our intellect, emotions and the ego. Suppose whole thing, even if we tell the central nervous system is the captain, any system can bring down the captain, or else captain can expose all the members of the team to degradation. Okay. Now, we all know that our central nervous system works quite fast. Correct? All the ladies are here. If they touch a very hot vessel in the kitchen, immediately their hand will move away. Okay. So it happens at approximately 80 to 120 meters per second. Means the moment you touch, it goes to the brain and sends the signal to the muscles. It happens at the speed of 80 to 100 or 120 meters per second. That is approximately 360 kilometers per hour. Okay. What is the speed of light? Lakh kilometers per second. So it is nothing in front of the speed of. Now we will humble the speed of light also. Okay. From sun to earth, what is the time?
8 minutes.
8 minutes. Means it starts from Baswangudi to reach Jainagar. Okay. If traffic is not much. Then if you see, the nearest star is Proxima Centauri. It takes 4.3 light years. Means today, whatever light we are receiving from this star was leaving that, had left that star 4.3 years back. Okay. And if you want to go to the other side of our galaxy, it would take 52,000 light years. So, the speed of light is, if you see the bigger picture, it is also slow. So, what do you think, what is faster than the speed of light?
Thought.
Very nice. All of us are excellent students of Vedanta. So, you close your eyes, you are at the other end of the galaxy. But that is in imagination. Okay. You close your eyes, you are at the sun. You can go anywhere. But there is a possibility where you know exactly how to do it. Because if it is in your mind, everything was once in our mind. And today it is in the manifestation. Okay. So whatever is in your mind, it can manifest. We all know that. How to do that is the question. Okay. Now, with that question, we'll come back to material once again. I just want to, I don't want to go into too much of detail about modern medicine kind of detail about spine. But yeah, some information which is useful for your spiritual growth, I will tell you. This spine is having 7 cervical vertebrae, which is in the neck, 12 thoracic vertebrae, then 5 lumbar vertebrae, and then a fused vertebral column of sacrum and the coccyx. If you see, it is a very beautiful structure which has a very firm base, and then it has some spine, spinous projection. That is why it is called a spine. The whole thing is called as vertebra, and inside that is the spinal cord, and as you saw, that spinal cord is connected to the brain, and through spinal cord the nerve roots are coming out, and in between these robust columns of vertebrae there are some cushions called as intervertebral discs. Okay. Now you remove the bone, and as we all know, this endoskeleton, it is doing a very big job of protecting your central nervous system. What exactly it is protecting? It is protecting the spinal cord. And inside that also there are beautiful layers of protection called as dura mater, called as arachnoid mater, called as pia mater. Within that there is blood vessels. These blood vessels, it is looking quite big on this, but if I have to operate, I have to go through a microscope which will be zooming in. And it will be, if you see through naked eye, it will be just like threads of the hairline, okay? And inside that there is a brain matter. That also is beautifully colored, not in the real aspect. There is slight difference. White and slight gray it looks. The central one is gray and the outer one is white, okay? The difference is because of the chemical composition. Once again, white one has more fat. Okay, because of that it conducts it at a very high speed, and gray does not have fat. This fat is called as myelin, and these are all the things which are derived from the fat you consume. So that is why people are discarding fat from the diet. They are not only harming themselves, they are harming their consciousness. Okay. Fat is very, very important. Suddenly this comes, one second, I like to zoom in and zoom out. Okay, so that is very important. What is this? The left side one, green one? The world satellite view, which is available on GMAP. If you do so much of zoom out, there will not be any boundaries. Okay, but if you zoom in, suddenly the political map will appear. They will show that this is Jammu and Kashmir, this much is occupied by China, this much is occupied by Pakistan, and then Nepal, Bhutan, then all the Indian states which are continuously dividing, Chhattisgarh and Jharkhand and Uttarakhand and all these things. Okay. Now, same subdivision is there in spine also. Why subdivision is important? Okay. Because there are ascending tracts and there are descending tracts. What are ascending tracts? They are the ones who are carrying the sensory information. Whether you are stamping on a corn or a glass piece, or you are walking on a grass. Means, is it a threat or it is a favorable stimulus? Okay. So, all these have to be beautifully segregated. If they are together, what will happen? If the wires are together, what happens generally?
Shock.
The central nervous system is electrical system. Okay, bioelectrical system. So it is very, very important for these bundles to be separate. Okay. This is a very simple way of representing what I was talking about, touching a hot vessel or stamping on a horn or anything. You receive the signal. If it is not good, in this much area it will go up and come down, and then tell that okay, this muscle has to work and this leg has to be removed. Okay, so that is how it works. It is called as spinal reflex arc. It is very, very important. Have you seen any person who does not get bothered by any pricking or by any threatful stimulus?
Paralyzed
people, yes. Blind people, we try to do, no? If somebody is, we think that, no, he is telling, he is not able to see. First thing we do is, in front of his eyes, we try to wave, or we try to do like this, and we try to find whether this person is feigning or is correctly seeing. Now, these all nerves, which I showed you, know, one by one, they were coming out. They are beautifully represented on the body. Almost every person's body will have this kind of distribution. The nerves, which are coming from respective levels of the spinal cord, they represent like this, C3, C4, C5, C6, and like this. And there is no variation. Slight variation of the area will be there, but overall the similar part of the body will be represented. Okay, that is why each and every part of the body is important. Now, motor also, what happens is each and every muscle movement is also coded, just like coding in the engineering, no? Same way it is coded. If you want to flex, this will be C5, C6. If you want to extend, it will be C6, 7, and so on. If you want to lift your leg, if you want to flex your leg, all these things, L2, L3, L4, L5, all these things are there. So how it is useful for me? Because it is just like mathematics. I check my patient from top to bottom, and I can say that at which level this spinal cord is affected. So this is our basic knowledge which we learn in our MBBS time. Okay?